喂喂喂，
好，喂喂，
快点把它
抹上哈，抹上。哎，喂，慢点，
队长。队长报，队长报，
队长报。
小心，队长报。要不要？
辩论主题是，如果试行回教啊、试行回教法，会否影响非回教徒？他的这个他的主题是这个，如果试行回教刑事法，会否啊？
就是他说回教刑事法对非穆斯林的影响。
对，那么就是回教刑事法会被试行，如果试行对非穆斯林的。会影响，这个是一个不可能发生的事件，回教刑事法根本不可能会被执行，所以这种来一个假设一种不可能会发生的事情来进行这个辩论，在辩论这种不可能会发生的事情，这个根本就没有意义，这是第二点，因为马哈迪、纳吉都承认，包括穆伊丁。昨天也承认，昨天的报章也承认，回教刑事法是不可能在马来西亚。他自己的老板，三大老板，都承认说，回教刑事法不可能被实行。所以他现在来假定，如果被实行的话，如果实行的话，会不会影响回教徒？这种拿一个不可能发生的假设来辩论他的那个不可能会发生的假设的。情形会怎样有什么影响？根本就是非常无聊。所以他如果要演独角戏，他自己去演；他如果要演戏，自己去演他的独角戏。他自己去跟他，我要求他自行去辩论，跟哪几辩论，看看到底回教刑事法能不能够执行。他如果能够统兵哪几。说回教刑事法是可以在马来西亚执行的话，那拿进公布了之后再来辩论。他现在拿进就讲不可能执行，穆伊丁也讲不可能执行，马哈迪也讲不可能。既然是这样的情况，根本你们拿一个不可能发生的事情来进行辩论，这个事件如果发生的话，会不会影响？它的影响是什么？这种根本是错误，而且他避开。真正关系到人民的，今天关系到人民的，不是一个他所列出的假设性的情况，而是他腐败滥权，国债高筑，人民债务，生活负担，这六个东西，这六个东西跟教育，这七大东西，他不敢辩论，去挑一些假设性而不可能发生的假设性的东西来辩论。所以这种是非常无聊，好无聊的。既然他不敢接受我的这个反挑战，那么整个辩论没有意义，所以不需要辩论。好，他可以自己去跟自己辩，或者他就选要哪几辩，跟哪几辩。OK， 好嘞。
到目前为止，他没有发出邀请信叫你上去。
哎，没有了，没有了啊。好，不过他报单上也可以了，不过我已经回应了，也算了了，也不需要说要他要麻烦他。
好，
好嘞，I think the, you're in English, right?
Double D.
Right? I think the challenge is that on the basis that if Wudu law is implemented, whether it will affect the non-Muslim. Yeah, it's an if question, hypothetical question. And what more to say, that hypothetical possibility has been refuted by Mahathir, Najib, and even Muhyiddin yesterday. All three of them said that it's impossible to implement Wudu law in Malaysia. Alright, so he is setting his debate is premised on an assumption of event which will not happen. Alright, so this is a meaningless debate. On the other hand, my counter challenge is to debate on corruption, abuses, and wastages, education, cost of living, and debt, national debt. All these issues, which are very important, which affect the everyday life of the rakyat, and he avoid that. So since he avoid the debate on this main issue, major issue concerning the rakyat, there's no point of debate. So since he did not dare to accept my challenge to debate, so I will not come. Alright. Only on the he insisted, he said he will not debate on other issues.
Now, as chairman of the branch and as a PR candidate for my
CAP. Mayor, don't worry.
I received from my secretary. This is what operation manager.
Wait,
it's okay, no problem. We are, this is our friend, man.
Yeah.
Maybe YB like to come to my medical office. That's why it's okay, no problem. We are friends, YBC also here, man.
Just then, door was locked.
It's because DAP is what operation director asking for explanation. So I inform him and YBC.
I will set
my explanation here. You see, this is a file going out in your letter. Major Sharon was actually is the SDR of enforcement officer for P195. So he was not acting on the direction of MBKS. Because here letter Usiagong, Major Sharon is the SDR officer, right? So therefore, any issue relating to e-enforcement, whatever done carried out by Major Sharon, should be actually referred to SBR, not to MBKS. I think this is unfair, but because Ilang Chi is in the process of election. In fact, reporter asking me about all the poster, everything, you go and read the papers, so I think it's only relating whatever poster one beside lah.
So this guy here, and then Major Shaharu.
Yeah,
he went over to the outside Kuching Airport International Airport to dispenser.
Yeah.
He is not acting as an officer of the MBKS.
Yes. Confirmed by me.
He is not.
Confirmed by mayor. Okay. Yes.
So he is acting as the SPR.
Yes. What beside more? Actually, I don't know. Okay. I never give instruction Okay, you take it from the mayor. I am answering to YB Chong here. Nothing to do with MBKS. That's why I was shocked.
No. P196.
Remember? No, hold on.
Because you see, mayor.
Hold on.
Please,
YB. You are a lawyer.
I know.
This is under SPR, so what?
He claims to be MBKS officer. He claims that.
Alright.
Kuching Airport is under the jurisdiction of MBKS.
No.
That's why he went there.
I didn't even know myself.
So, okay. Since it's clear, we will go after that.
Come on, kill her.
It's basically we want to deny that this so-called person, Brother Matthew, is a non-member of DAP. He has never been. No, he. Yeah, I deny that he is a member. He is not a member. He has never been in our election team, and he has nothing to do with our election campaign. Here is our director of operation. He is here. And he is the assistant director of operation. So we have the people, not Matthew, you said. This is basically make a story to us. Matthew, you said, is a bogus person, a bogus officer for the election. He's not a member of our team. Okay? All right?
Hey, I still have one.
And for Serian, I wish to call upon Dato' Richard Rio to be gentleman, because our posters, our billboards have been taken down, and we have been told that he even directed people to pull down our banners and our billboards. I want to call upon him to be gentleman, please. And I would like to call upon Richard to tell all his workers to behave themselves and not to do unlawful act. If Dato' Richard cannot do that, then he is not fit to be a leader. Okay. Yes, Nathan Kunai. He is Master Stewart Wujang, and all our. He's our assistant director of operation.
And the committee are all here.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Din disappear.
Okay. One for the family. They have played for the family.